Jeanette, when we first met, I felt immediately drawn to you. I remember seeing a beautiful girl with an amazing laugh and smile. Since then, all I want to do is spend more time around you. Together, we have traveled the world and shared many adventures. You have given me the greatest gift of all, our beautiful daughter, Annabelle.
Honey, you're my best friend, and you're the man of my dreams. I can't imagine life without you. Therefore, I, Jeanette, call upon the persons here present to witness that I take you, Waitat, to be my lawful wedded husband.
This has been a perfect day today, and it's been an honour to witness the union between Dr. Waitat Phung and Dr. Jeanette Yuen.
I'm sure that when Jeanette and Waitat were dreaming about their wedding day, they couldn't have imagined it being quite as special if all of you weren't here. It is the love, guidance and encouragement that you have given to these two over the years that have helped shape them into who they are.
You've inherited your intelligence and witty nature, culinary skills and hard work ethic from both your parents. You've always kept your head down and focused and listened to your mother. It's wonderful to see you grow into such a loving and dedicated father and still manage those gym gains. Between cousins, we nicknamed Waitat the Unicorn. The Unicorn because he never attended anything. We never saw him. So answering his phone or messages is definitely not his strong suit. And in fact, the building project manager we shared thought he had passed away because he never answered his phone.
Many of you expect me to give you the dirt on Jeanette from our childhood growing up together. But if I'm honest, there isn't any. Jeanette has always been the perfect little sister, perfect daughter that my mum and dad could have hoped for. When I was 7, I saw for the first time someone dinking somebody on their bike, and I wanted to try it out on Jan. Jan was my first passenger. I took it down the street as fast as I could. We hit a curb and both of us flew over the handlebars. We were bruised, cut and bleeding. Janet was crying. I then picked her up and carried her a whole block home. At this point, when I brought it to my dad, I was crying because I knew I was going to cop a beating. But Jan looked at me, she stopped crying, and she said, "Vic, Lewis, my Vietnamese name, look, I'm okay. I'm not hurt." And she gave me a hug and she forgave it.
Jeanette, the first time we met you was Christmas lunch 8 years ago in Rockingham. I will be honest, the general feeling of that day was one of confusion. The only thing we knew about you was Waitat's like, "Oh, hey, this is Jan." We had no idea who you were, but thankfully we got to meet you again. You're intelligent, graceful, an amazing baker. Your kindness is certainly an inspiration to us all. Thanks to you, Waitat has attended every family event since that time.
We cannot forget the reason we are here today, a proposal that took place at Wine Glass Bay in Tasmania. It was exactly the 14th of December. Both went on a hike when they reached the peak to sit down for a well-deserved break and snacks. But he found a moment, his perfect moment, when he asked her the question and asked her if she would make him the happiest man alive. Her answer was obviously a resounding yes.
I promise you, always support your passions and goals so that you can achieve all your dreams. I promise to never take you for granted. Make sure you feel heard and feel valued. I promise you that we can get through anything life throws at us as long as we stick together.
I promise to love you and to be your best friend. I promise to be patient with you. I promise to respect and support you as we work together to accomplish our dreams. I promise to share my life with you forever.